Hey, greetings and welcome to another episode of the Almost World Famous Cactus Atlas. On today's episode, Amy and I are getting our sea legs together. We're here at Patagonia Lake State Park in southern Arizona. We're gonna be renting a pontoon boat to celebrate my birthday. Thought we'd have a good day out on the lake, experience boating for the first time, we've never done it, as well as scout out some future campsite locations for a future campground guide episode, because they have some amazing boat-in only campgrounds here that we want to check out. So we'll take a quick look here at the different rental options you have. You got kayaks, you got canoes, rowboats. So you can see there's tons of different options for you here. We of course did the most expensive thing because it's my birthday. We rented a pontoon boat. So my first time driving a motorized craft as an adult. So far it's a piece of cake. I don't know why I was nervous. You know, if you're new to boating like we are, this being Amy and I's first time really doing this, I think this is a great opportunity to learn and to take your time and not feel too much pressure, because we haven't seen anybody out on the lake today other than maybe two people that were fishing on the west side of the lake. If you want to have an easy time with it, I guess come out here in November during the week if you can and have at it.
Okay, and here we have our boat. And as you can see, there's plenty of seating up front, probably for about four people. Little eating area, plenty of seating for more guests. You've got a ladder in case you want to go swimming. And the gentleman was nice enough to put the canopy up, so we have a little bit of shade. All right, and we have Glenn at the wheel here.
Aye, aye. We really don't have too much of an agenda today. We just wanted to rent a boat and give this a try and just enjoy the scenery. I think one thing that interests me is checking out some of these boat-in campgrounds, because I do want to come back and do it, and I wanted to get a sense for how does this actually work. This is an interesting site here, site 109. It's a very small campsite, not level at all. Honestly, I don't know where you'd put a tent. Despite it being kind of a small site, it is really cool. Your fire grill is right there on the edge by the water, which is really awesome. Here's another really cool boat inside. It looks like 110. This one's pretty clear and nice. It's clean back there. Really like this one. So we wanted to check out one of these boat-in campgrounds, and 111 is supposed to be amazing. This is site 111, which is supposed to be one of the better ones here. You can see pontoon boat, got in here no problem. You could also bring in a non-motorized craft like a rowboat. You do get a nice little fire pit with a grill attached. So similar to things we've seen in national parks on our adventures. You also get a nice little picnic table in here, and you are in the shade. Really awesome shade. You do get a trash can, which is quite full. And they do have porta-johns spread out, but we talked to the guy at the visitor center and they are all closed. So yeah, you have to take care of all that yourself. This is absolutely beautiful back here and as private as you can get, because these boat insights are very spread out. There's a cow here in the site. And another encounter with animals here on the Cactus Atlas. Perfect. So just like the other campsites, I mean, you get the same thing. Slightly different style fire pit with a grill, trash can, plenty of room to set up a tent, very level. There's also another campsite over here that I'm gonna go check out really quick. And this is site 112. Here you get your fire grill, and someone did a number here with the rocks too. So these sites are pretty good too, sites 112 and 113, although they are really close to each other. I'm in site 112 right now, and the bull is occupying site 113 at the moment. So this is site 119, which is a private island you can reserve here on the lake. Right off the bat, I see a trash can, picnic table. I mean, how cool is that? Being able to camp on your own island seems pretty cool to me. So site 119 is one of two that really interest me. It's the smaller of what's supposed to be two islands. Site 120 is another island that I want to go find here. So site 120 is on its own island, and you can see it's quite a sizable little island for your campsite here. This is the biggest campsite I've seen yet. This is an amazing campsite. I would love to spend the night over here. And lots of very beautiful fall color back here, folks. I thought fall was over already here in Arizona. I think it might just be in its prime or just kind of starting here in the very southern climes of Arizona. A really cool thing about this is that with all these dead leaves, it actually smells like the woods. Such a cool campsite. Come on, look at that. Anyway, that was site 120 right back there. That is probably my favorite site that I've seen today. I would say that and site 11 would be the two so far that I'd really like to camp on. All right, one last thing to do, which is to pull this thing back in here. So this is gonna test everything I've learned today. Well, unfortunately, we have to wrap it up for the day. We got a long drive home. This was a perfect birthday, I would say. Something that you don't really think of doing for a birthday, but ended up being the perfect thing. So maybe keep that in mind if you're looking to do something for somebody special. Perfect place to consider coming for a day, renting a boat, and enjoying the day. If you're new here, please subscribe to our channel. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, hit that notification bell to stay informed of any time we release new videos, which we're doing all the time. You can also find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas. Well, thank you so much for joining us on this epic adventure today. This was one of the best birthdays that I've had in recent memory. So Amy, thank you for braving this with me. And we hope to see you all on a new adventure right around the corner. So keep checking back in.